Repository Tool, Genomic Data Commons, GDC 2.0 Video Guides, Bill Wysocki, PhD, GDC User Services Lead, Center for Translational Data Science, University of Chicago. The GDC Data Portal 2.0 Repository Tool allows users to download harmonized data files that are associated with a specific cohort. In this GDC video tutorial, we will download the RNA-seq expression count data plus the clinical supplements for our active cohort, which was previously created with lung cancer patients who were 50 years of age or older at diagnosis and had associated RNA-seq data. For information on creating a cohort, see the Cohort Builder tutorial video. Starting at the Data Portal homepage, portal.gdc.cancer.gov, the repository tool can be reached by clicking on the repository icon at the top left of the page, the fourth icon from the left. The repository tool can also be reached from the Analysis Center by finding the Core Tools section in the center of the screen and clicking on the Play button within the repository tile. Introduction to the repository tool page. The repository tool table includes all files that are associated with the active cohort. The top of the table displays summary information about the files, such as the number of files, number of cases, and the file size of the entire data set. The top of the table also includes buttons to download the table in JSON or TSV format. Choose the button at the top right to add or remove columns by toggling the switch, and reorder columns using the pad at the left side of each name. The search box can be used to filter the table using a file ID or file name. In the table header, the table can be sorted by choosing the up or down arrow next to the column names. The table columns have some basic properties that describe each file, including access, which tells us if a file is open access or controlled, which requires dbgap permission. Cases, which tells us how many cases are associated with the one file. Clicking on this number will bring up the case detail page pop-up, which displays information about the case, file counts by data category and experimental strategy, clinical data, and biospecimen data. Clicking the file name will bring up the file entity page pop-up, which displays details about the file, including the biospecimen entity, such as the case or aliquot, that the file is associated with. The drop-down at the bottom left of the table allows us to select the number of files for each page or browse to a different page. Filtering files in the repository. Files may be filtered using the cards at the left panel of the repository. Each card contains the values for one file-related field, which can be selected or deselected by clicking the box to the left of each value. Since we would like to download clinical supplement files for our cohort, we will click on Clinical under the Data Category card, which is the top card. See how the rest of the cards update in real time as filters are applied. To filter further, we will click on Clinical Supplement under Data Type. Additional fields that do not appear by default can be added using the Add a Custom Filter button at the top of the portal. This concludes the first filtering step, and a manifest for the resulting 1,077 files can be downloaded by choosing the Manifest button above the table. This can be used to download these files with the GDC Data Transfer tool. The filters can be reset by choosing the circular arrow buttons. Now that the filters have been reset, we would like to download the RNA-seq gene expression count files for our cohort. For RNA-seq files, we will use the experimental strategy card. Click on the magnifying glass icon to search for RNA-seq and choose that value. To specifically download the gene expression counts file, we will select star counts under the workflow type card and gene expression quantification under the data type card. Scrolling down to the access card, we can see that open is the only available option, which indicates that the list we have filtered only has open access files. There are 1,630 files across 1,223 cases, which gives a total of 6.91 gigabytes. This time, we will add these files to the cart. Each of the cart buttons at the leftmost column can be used to add them to the cart one by one. But since we have so many files, we will use the Add All Files to Cart button at the top of the table. The cart icon at the very top right of the portal shows a highlighted number, which indicates that 1,630 files are currently in the cart. Clicking the cart icon will bring us to the cart page. Using the cart page. The cart page has three tables with information about the files in the cart. The table at the top left tells us which files we are authorized to download. Since they are all open access files, we are authorized to download all of them. The table at the top right gives a breakdown of the files in the cart by project. This includes the number of represented cases, number of files, and the total file size for each project. The bottom table provides a list of files in the cart with a similar design as the table in the main repository page. The main difference is that instead of a button for adding files to the cart, the first column contains a trash can button to remove each file from the cart. The top has three options from left to right: download cart, download associated data, and remove from cart. The download cart button allows us to download the files in the cart and has two options. Manifest downloads a manifest for the files in the cart. Cart downloads the data files, which are bundled together in a tar.gz file. The download associated data button allows for metadata about the set of files in the cart to be downloaded. There are six options here. Clinical data about the cases associated with the files can be downloaded in JSON or TSV format. Note that TSV formatted clinical data is separated by entity type, since many-to-one relationships are present in GDC clinical data. Biospecimen data about the files can be downloaded in JSON or TSV format. The sample sheet, which is a TSV formatted file with commonly used information about each file and its related biospecimen entities, can be downloaded. Metadata downloads all information about the files in JSON format. The Remove from Cart button allows for files to be removed from the cart and has two options. All files removes all files from the cart so that the cart is empty. Unauthorized files removes only the files that are labeled unauthorized. For more information on the GDC data portal, please refer to the other videos or go to docs.gdc.cancer.gov.